it sends a signal to other healthcare providers and health systems that these kind of allegations are going to be taken very seriously. And that sends a very powerful message across the country.
A major step forward in an explosive whistleblower lawsuit against UPMC and the longtime head of its cardiothoracic surgery department. We first told you about the case last fall, and now a judge denied the hospital's efforts to get the case dismissed, so it will move forward in federal court.
And Channel 11's Angie Moreski here tonight with us in the studio with more information on this case. And Angie, some very troubling allegations here.
You know, David and Lisa, they really are. The federal government has accused UPMC and one of its star surgeons of regularly sacrificing patient health in order to maximize profit. Now, with this new order denying the defendant's motion to dismiss, the judge wrote, "With all this smoke, a fire is plausible, so the case should proceed."
UPMC's renowned cardiothoracic surgeon, Dr. James Lukatich, is accused of repeatedly putting patients at risk by conducting as many as three complex surgeries at the same time without being present for all key portions, forcing patients to endure hours of unnecessary anesthesia time, and then falsely billing the government for those procedures. Taxpayers Against Fraud, a nonprofit which monitors government whistleblower suits, says potential harm is the major issue here.
These allegations are concerning to the government, and they tend only to get involved in very big cases or cases that potentially involve patient harm.
The complaint says several of Lukatich's patients suffered complications, including painful pressure ulcers, deep tissue injuries, and in at least two cases, amputations. We're also getting our first look at redacted portions of the complaint, which were just recently unsealed. One section alleging there are at least 15 examples of these practices between 2015 and 2019, including one in 2016 where two patients were under general anesthesia in different ORs with towels covering surgical wounds, and there was no progress for 4 hours with no one able to locate Lukatich for nearly an hour. The complaint also says UPMC persistently ignored or minimized complaints by its own employees, continuing to allow Lukatich to skirt the rules and endanger the patients.
That's a real thing that raises a lot of red flags for a lot of people, whether they're patients or employees. Is there a culture, a speak-up culture, or is there a culture where people turn a blind eye? And the allegations here is that UPMC turned a blind eye to what happened here.
Another recently unredacted section says UPMC's chief quality officer wrote in an email that it was crazy and against the law for a doctor to service two patients simultaneously, except in cases of emergency.
As the judge says, there's smoke here and there likely is fire. We need to look further into this case.
Now, UPMC would not comment today on the judge's order. In a past statement, though, the hospital said the government misinterpreted its internal policies and it would vigorously defend against the lawsuit. And David and Lisa, it's worth noting that the judge in her order also suggested both sides might want to try mediation so we could end up seeing a settlement, which is very common in these cases.
Well, right. We will see what happens. Thanks, Angie.